Hi there, this is Mark Barnabas, your data protection pal, and once again, we have a fortnight of data protection updates and news. The biggest news this fortnight is really just a few days ago where the US government declares an emergency after a cyber attack on a major pipeline. Yes, Colonial Fuel Pipeline has been hacked by hackers, driving President Biden to call on an emergency. And this is really major. I mean, the whole entire East Coast of US is going to be greatly affected, causing oil prices to surge and all share prices to really go into the red. I just couldn't imagine if this happened to a small, tiny country like Singapore, where there's no natural resources and the country is fully dependent on imports. So countries must really be able to handle cyber attacks. And I believe every single person has a responsibility to contribute to ensure personal safety with good cyber hygiene. So please be good online. So second news is about a smart vehicles. You know, GDPR in Europe has started to look into guidelines for vehicles because I guess vehicles are getting smarter. I mean, just last week I test drive the Hyundai Ioniq 5 and it was really cool. I was driving on the road with hands-free. Although the car was not able to really stop or slow down in front of other cars as well as I hoped, the cars are getting really smart, and they're so smart because there's several cameras all around the cars, and these cameras could pose some privacy risk as well. So I guess there's going to be more guidelines. Looking forward to it soon. But on the note of AI, I'm kind of proud that Singapore is the first country in the world that has got a artificial intelligence guidelines. So let's see what happens in the rest of the world, and let's see what GDPR comes up, because they are, after all, the leaders in data protection. And of course, this news kind of like, it's good news for some people, but of course, not so good for some people like me who are training and teaching an advisory on data protection. The Thai cabinet is going to delay the enforcement of the Personal Data Protection Act in Thailand due to the pandemic. And this pandemic has really caused a lot of disruptions, I guess. So, well, let's look forward to seeing more companies coming on, and I guess companies in Thailand have one more year to get themselves ready for the implementation of PDPA in Thailand. And back to China, we have been following China quite a bit with regards to data protection after the introduction of the draft law with regards to PIPL, the Personal Information Protection Law. They're still calling for revisions and calling organizations, and I'll definitely put in my little feedback. Of course, it's all in Chinese, and well, I keep reading in Chinese. Not so easy to read in Chinese. But those of you who would like a copy of the draft PIPL, please ping me. I'll be glad to send a copy down to you. And from China, we head on to USA, California. CCPA is going to be changed to CPRA. I mean, sometimes these things just baffles me. Why do they want to keep changing names? But one big improvement is, I guess, this is where the US is going to go towards perhaps a federal law on data protection. Well, we look forward to seeing something from the US really soon. And on the update for protection of data, after all the bad news, well, we hear some good news, where there's a lot more technology to help us protect our data. I mean, I personally am using an iPhone 8. Yes, the ancient iPhone 8, partly because there's fingerprint. It's the only iPhone that still has fingerprint other than the iPhone SE. So, I mean, I personally have issues with facial recognition. I don't know about you. So, well, I'm glad to know that there are a lot more tools and, well, defenses with regards to protection of personal data using better facial recognition tools. So we look forward to seeing these implemented in a new iPhone, and then maybe I'll upgrade to the iPhone X or 12 or maybe 13 by then. And well, my name is Mark Barnabas, your data protection pal, and I look forward to seeing you again real soon. And my game, Data Heist, is going to be introduced very soon. It's going to the production line very soon, and we look forward to seeing it in this time in June. So meanwhile, take care, be safe, and be good. Please remember to like, subscribe, and my name is Mark Barnabas. Feel free to connect me on my social media cradles. See you again real soon, and yes, be safe.